That wind has calmed down quite a bit now, man. It was raging before. I mean, it's been going between 15 and probably 40 miles an hour all day long. When I first come in this woods, I guess it's been over 10 or maybe even 15 years now, I didn't even notice any of these small beaches that you see now. It looks like they've been here more than 15 years though, but they were probably just tiny little saplings when I first started hunting here, and they're actually starting to grow up now. That's one of the last trees to lose its leaves in the fall. Usually the oaks hold on to their leaves, and once the oaks drop their leaves, then the beech trees are right there or just behind them. Nice little woods though. But when I first come in here 15 years ago, I thought these were all maple trees. That's how little I knew about just paying attention and looking around me. All I would have had to done is look down, and I could have seen they were all oaks. But I didn't know how to tell a tree by the bark, and there might have actually been snow on the ground, I don't recall, but now that I've been in here a while, I realize it's predominantly oaks with a few scrub brush and some beech and a couple maple mixed in and the occasional cherry tree. Here in Michigan, we don't have a lot of spectacular wilderness areas. We have lots of wilderness areas, but there's nothing too spectacular to me about any of them. It's generally just hardwoods and fields, and we don't have any mountains to say. We don't really have any mountains compared to other places. And we only have one big waterfall that I know of, and that's up in the UP, Tecumseh Falls. But this is what it's all about for me. Just getting out in the woods and enjoying nature, you know. Whether I'm out camping or just out hiking or hunting or fishing, or if I'm just out learning to identify plants and mushrooms and trees and stuff. It's kind of like my endless hobby. I can never learn everything, no matter how hard I try. And even if I get really skilled in one area, like plants or mushrooms, there's always a bunch of other areas that I know nothing about, like different methods of starting fire or shelter craft or woodcraft, carving stuff out of wood. I mean, the list just goes on and on. That's why I like bushcraft so much, because it allows me to get out in the woods and be where I want to be. And allows me just to enjoy nature. And I know Skog Knife from Bushcraft USA forums, he posted a video on YouTube, and he asked, you know, what is bushcraft to you? And that's what bushcraft is to me. You know, it's not necessarily about making fire or making knives or making pottery or baskets or carving utensils out of wood or hunting or fishing. It's all of it. It's anything to do with the outdoors. That's what bushcraft is to me. When I'm out in the woods or the fields or at a lake, that's bushcraft to me. It's just about getting out in God's creation and enjoying what the good Lord gave us.